Good morning, everybody. It is January 14th, Friday. I've got a bunch of little things to do today. I'm going to just try to give myself a little bit of a break. I have to print out some charts for a project next week, and I'm going to start going over them, making some of musical copious notes on those charts. Since I have some demos that reflect what they want, I'll make some notations on that. Let's see. It's a beautiful day out. The sky is blue and it's kind of whitish gray clouds. It drizzled a little bit yesterday, but only a tiny bit. I would love to get a little more moisture in the yard, but I'm sure we'll get some. I'm going to do an artist today that people have asked me about for quite a long time. And so I've finally, I don't believe I've done him in the past. I kind of went through my videos and his name hasn't popped up yet. So if I did do it, I think he's worth a revisit anyhow. But this was a really cool project and I'm gonna read a little about him. His name was Jimmy Spheeris. And I pulled it up on Wikipedia. And Jimmy, and here's what it says, and then I'll get to my notes about the project that we did, because I think I did a couple of things with him back in the day. Jimmy Spheeris was born in, it's Phoenix City, Alabama, P-H-E-N-I-X. I'd never heard of that one. Phoenix City, Alabama, to Juanita Gypsy was her nickname, and Andrew Spheeris, who owned and operated a traveling carnival called the Magic Empire. These childhood years of colorful transience wore a major influence on later work, as evidenced in songs such as Lost in the Midway and Decatur Street, among others. Spheeris had two sisters, Penelope, who's a famous director, and Linda, and a brother, Andy. After his father was murdered by a belligerent carnival goer, Gypsy Spheeris moved the family to San Diego, California. The family eventually settled in Venice, California. Gypsy Spheeris tended a bar at an establishment on Main Street called The Circle. Spheeris moved to New York City in the late 60s to pursue his songwriting career. The liner notes on his debut album credit friend and fellow songwriter Richie Havens, who introduced Spheeris to Columbia Records executive Clive Davis. Davis signed Spheeris to a 4-album recording deal, and his debut album was released on the Columbia label. Spheeris's 72 debut album, Isle of Views, garnered a devoted following in FM radio play, most notably the song I Am the Mercury. His 1973 album, the original Tap Dancing Kid, was followed by a period of extensive concert touring. Spheeris returned to the recording studio in 75 with The Dragon Is Dancing and released Ports of the Heart in 76. After Ports of the Heart, Spheeris had no recording contract except for a 1980 single, Hold Tight. Spheeris released no new material through a major record label. Now, this is the tragic part. Spheeris died at the age of 34 in Santa Monica, California, when his motorcycle collided with a van at 2 a.m. on the morning of July 4th, 1984. The driver of the van, Bruce Burnside, was charged with driving under the influence of alcohol and felony vehicular manslaughter. Hours before his death, Spheeris finished the self-titled album, Spheeris, which was produced by Paul Delph. The final album was not publicly released for 16 years. Delph would later record two of Spheeris's songs on his final album, A God That Can Dance. And it goes on to some other things, but just, you know, really unbelievable that, that I remember when I heard that Jimmy had been killed in an accident. It was just shocking. Because he was a really great guy to be in the studio with. I mean, we had a ball recording. And so one of the things I did with him was that album, the original Tap Dancing Kid, and that was 1973. And it was produced by Felix Cavallari from the Young Rascals, which became the Rascals, and Felix is great. He's the keyboard player in the group, and just a fabulous musician and the sweetheart of a guy. And we recorded the album at the record plant, the old record plant down on I think it was on 3rd Street, down in Hollywood near La Cienega. Used to work there all the time. Boy, it was one of those things. You'd go there and you'd see, you know, in those days of those studios, you'd walk around from studio to studio, and everybody you could imagine was there. They had a number of rooms, and they ran around the clock. And so you'd see, oh God, I mean, just name it, you know, and those artists would be there because that was one of the main rooms in Los Angeles. So I'm gonna play a couple of songs here from this album. I'll do the title track was the original Tap Dancing Kid. And on this track, it's myself, Russ Kunkel, Jeff Levin on guitar, Jane Getz on piano and harmony. Now, Jane Getz, I did an album with her called Mother Hen. And I actually just heard from her recently. She's another wonderful artist that will be featured. Doreen Davis is doing harmony. And then Norma Trotter is tap dancing on this. So here we go. This is the original Tap Dancing Kid, Jimmy Spheeris from the album The Original Tap Dancing Kid from 1973.
A thunderbolt, the original tap dancing kid. I would have given anything just to sing the way he did. He'd serenade the wayward girls beneath the moon and the stars, sneak down by the waterhole, smoking on a dad's cigars. The girls were wild. My brother was a thunderbolt, the original tap dancing kid. Blaze a trail around the sun. Back. You shoot the rapids on the mighty river, yes, and howl like Wolfman Jack. They gave our boy a glad hand. They said, son, what you going to do? Yes, I'm gonna roll my happy hunting grounds in my funky pair of candy shoes. The girls were wild about him. Yes, and Jimmy flipped her lid. My brother was a thunderbolt, the original tap dancing kid. Jackson 5, I always think of him. He says, listen to me, brother, is that hope for a native son? Yes, well, don't expect no fanfare here. They only give it to you when you're young. The girls were wild about him. Yes, that Jenny flipped to me. Was a thunderbolt, the original tap dancing kid.
It's a little odd to me that going through all the credits on this, that there was nobody credited for playing fiddle on this, and fiddle is a dominant instrument on the track. But I look back at credits, at least the ones I've seen so far did not credit anybody with that. That's always the tough part of going through all of these things, is finding really who did what. I don't know. Here's another phone. This is called Sweet Wahini Mama. And this is myself, Felix Cavallari on piano B3 and vocal harmonies, Bobby Hall on percussion, I love Bobby, Sneaky Pete Kleinow on steel, and Doreen Davis on harmony vocals. So here we go, the Sweet Wahini Mama. Another track, when you look at credits, there's no drums listed. I mean, Russ Kunkel's playing drums on every other track here, and he's listed on them. So it's just weird that he didn't on this one, but that's obviously drums being played on here. And boy, Pete was one of the more unique, interesting pedal steel players of any of the ones I've ever worked with. He would come in sometimes and just plug a whole bunch of effects in and just create walls of sound and stuff. He looked at it from a whole, he did great traditional pedal steel, but he also went at it from a pretty left field approach sometimes, which really made some tracks really amazing, because you'd go, what the hell is that sound in there? What's that? And it would be Pete in there. Here's a song called Village Vapors, and it's myself, Russ Kunkel on drums, Jeff Levin on 12-string guitar, Felix Cavallari on B3, Jane Getz, Mother Hen, on piano, and all of these, Jimmy Spheeris' guitar vocals on all the tracks. And sometimes he's also piano on them. Here we go, Village Vapors. Let me get that top start on the downbeat. Thank you.
noise of some young tattooed boys, some hot dogs, sweet water, dyke debutantes. Well, if you know what you want, you can get what you want. And in these village vapors, some think it's so groovy. Know where you are, then it's like a horror movie with vampire desires, Jesus and hellfire, and black naked nuns that walk a tight wire. Well, if you know where you are, then you better stay there. Laughing at the space gates, they'll stay here and pray every day for a way to get out, something about the pure light of day. But if you know what you are, then it just don't matter. No, 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 no. No, 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 no.
Tastes of all kinds of stuff in there, from like early Buffett to Sean Phillips, all kinds of stuff. Bass I used on all of these tracks was my old Peace Love bass, my carved up 62 jazz bass. This all precedes Frankenstein. We built Frankenstein like the following year. So this is the same one I used on Spectrums and Stratus and Doctor My Eyes and the early James Taylor stuff and all that. Sitting in the other room, still a great instrument. Love it. Love it. One more quick tune here, and then I'll get running and let you get off on your day, too. This is called A Shirt Full of Apples, and it's me and Russ Kunkel and Felix Cavallari on piano, Jim Calgar on flute, and Jeff Levin on acoustic guitar. Here we go. And Jimmy Spheeris of guitar vocals.
Shirt full of apples and the skies with rain. I wanna walk down to the river while this whole world aches with shame. Shirt full of apples, how our fathers complain with their hands full of memory and their eyes full of pain. The cider is sour. So won't you leave me alone?
Offering.
I'll turn your weapons all to flowers. I will make wings out of your bones. Shirt full of apples, now the orchards are gone. All the blossoms have been blinded. When something's wrong. Shirt full of apples, all the lies have been said. They take their misery to the rainbow and all their sorrows to bed. The cider is sour, so won't you leave me alone? I'll turn your weapons all the flowers. flowers, I will make wings out of your bones.
Quite a free-for-all there at the end. Everybody stepping up to the plate and taking a swing, as one might say. So Jimmy Spheeris, I mean, the tragedy of that is that he died so young and so unnecessarily by being nailed by a drunk driver. It's just unbelievable. I've known a number of them, though, that similar situations happen to. And it's always so shocking when it happens, because, you know, at that age, you don't expect it. But there's a whole bunch of really great songs on this album. And so if you're inclined, check out the original Tap Dancing Kid, Jimmy Spheeris, from 1973. I'm going to get running now. I'm going to just thank everybody who's working, you know, just in the hospitals, you know, this is a daily thing. So many hospitals are packed just to capacity and beyond capacity at this point. And you hear the doctors talking and they say, really, the real answer to this is vaccination. So I just, please just do it. Do it. This shouldn't be a political statement or any kind of stuff like that. This is a public health statement and a critical sociological statement at this point to get our world back on track. So just asking you to think about doing what I feel is the right thing, but you make up your own decision for this. But all the hospitals that are packed, and especially with people that are in grave condition, are the unvaxxed. It should be pretty obvious, you know, what the scene is. So I'm going to get going. I'm going to wish everybody a great day. Be back tomorrow with something else. And we'll be in the weekend and find something. Maybe I'll play over the weekend. I got lots of work to do. So we'll talk later. And next Wednesday is Clubhouse. Put it on your calendar for all you Clubhouse members. And we'll catch up then. So see you tomorrow. Okay, bye-bye.